All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those against say nay. The motion is carried.
Bill 52, entitled An Act to Amend Chapter 231 of the Revised Statutes 1989, the Insurance Act.
Order that this bill do pass. Order that the title be as read by the clerk. Order that the bill be engrossed. The Honorable Government House Leader.
Mr. Speaker, with the indulgence of the House, could we please revert the order of business presenting reports of committees?
Agreed.
Is it agreed?
Agreed.
It is agreed. Presenting reports of committees, private and local bills, the Honourable Member for Halifax Atlantic.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I would like to report that I have been instructed by the Committee on Private and Local Bills to report back to the House that the committee has met and considered without representation the following bills and recommends them without amendment to the House. Bill number 43, First Cornwallis Baptist Church Act, and Bill number 49, the Royal Cape Breton Yacht Club Act. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
And I'll leave there. Thank you. Thank you. Honourable Government House Leader. Order these bills be referred to the Committee of the Whole House on bills. The Honourable Government House Leader.
Mr. Speaker, with the indulgence of the House, I wonder if we could move these bills directly to third reading.
Agreed.
And do these bills
agreed? Is that agreed?
Agreed?
It is agreed. The Honourable Government House Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I call private and local bills for third reading.
Private and local bills for third reading.
Mr. Speaker, please call bill number 43, the Congregation of the Baptist Church of Kennard.
Third reading of bill number 43. Is the House ready for the question? The question has been called. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those against say nay. The motion is carried.
Bill 43, entitled An Act to Amend Chapter 6 of the Acts of 1844, an act to authorize the congregation of the Baptist Church at Kennard in Cornwallis to appoint trustees to take charge of the said church and cemetery adjoining the same and to enclose and ornament the same.
Order this bill do pass. Order the title be read by the clerk. Order that the bill be engrossed. The order, Honorable Government House Leader.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, could you please call bill number 49, the Royal Cape Breton Yacht Club.
Bill number 49, the Royal Cape Breton Yacht Club Act. The question is being called. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those against say nay. The motion is carried.
Bill 49, title An Act to Amend Chapter 283 of the Acts of 1903, an act to incorporate the Royal Cape Breton Yacht Club.
Order this bill do pass. Order that the title be as read by the clerk. Order that the bill be engrossed. The Honourable Government House Leader.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And while there's some other committees still meeting, I would ask the Speaker to please call address and reply, the speech from the throne.
Address and reply to the speech from the throne. The Honourable Deputy Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, it's been some time, Mr. Speaker, since I've had a reply to the speech from the throne, Mr. Speaker. I knew when I made my last one, it wasn't that far from Montreal Canadiens winning the Stanley Cup, but it was still quite a distance since the Boston Bruins had won one. And even further for the Leafs fans. Yeah, well, you know. But Mr. Speaker, I say that by reflecting that many things change and Many things stay the same. But you know, Mr. Speaker, I'm going to use my time in this House today not to be overtly political partisan, but I really want to take the time because it's been roughly about four elections since I've had a chance to stand in this House and talk about the people who you meet and work with and campaign against in this democracy that we participate in, Mr. Speaker. And you know, it's interesting because there's, to quite honestly say, that overused saying that there's an elephant in the room, and that elephant happened to be about the expenses of members. And Mr. Speaker, I'm not going to spend much time on that, but what I want to talk about, though, in that relation was that there's very many good women and men who sat in this House and who've run and offered from one end of this province to the other for public office. And behind all those women and men were literally hundreds and thousands of people who supported them and saw them as good people that they wanted to serve. And Mr. Speaker, at the end of this speech, if somebody out there anywhere has happened to see this and said, well, this is just another self-serving politician, well, then that's their right. I agree with them to be wrong. Because what it's about, elections are about our celebration of democracy, our celebration of going out and reaching out to the people and engaging them. And one could say every 4 years, but Mr. Speaker, my 12 plus years, I think this has been my fifth or sixth election. And I've got to say, Mr. Speaker, there's not a day that I don't stand in this marvelous chamber and be of awe of the people that have gone before us in here. And the ones that sit here now, I'm quite sure I can speak for them, that they understand the special place that they're allowed to stand and speak in, and they do not take that lightly, Mr. Speaker. You know, there's days of very heated debate, there's days of great arguments, there's days of frivolity, there's days of calling people brilliant, and there's days of throwing kisses, Mr. Speaker. But you know, Mr. Speaker, yes, but
kiss.
Yeah, a moment on your lips, a lifetime enhanced. But you know, Mr. Speaker, I want to spend my time today talking about the many friends that I've met on the way, and this is from all political stripes. I remember in 98 running and I think this goes for a lot of us that are first timers in this milieu, and you realize or you think that, you know, I can't wait to get to Halifax, that's where the work is done. But Mr. Speaker, the reality is we know when you're here for a while where the work is done. It's back home. It's the hand-to-hand combat, so to speak, of back home and helping your constituents. And indeed, the importance of legislation helps us to do that. But it's those folks, Mr. Speaker, that I would look around and I know I'm not mentioning that there's any empty seats, but if every one of those seats were full, that I could look each and every member in the eye and say, well, yeah, we differ on things, but we agree on a basic thing about support for our people back home. And I got to say in the record today, Mr. Speaker, when people say this phrase, you're all the same. Well, I look at all my contemporaries in this building, and if that means I'm like each and every one of you, then I'm glad to be all the same, Mr. Speaker. If that means we're all the same, And that means I'm like the late Michael Baker? That's a compliment, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, there's many people who've come and gone in this House, both from electoral and gone to their reward, Mr. Speaker. And there's many I could talk about today. But I'm proud. I'm proud. There's been, you know, like any group, a reflective society. Things happen. But yet, people want to, people, I don't, and it's such a silly word to say, like we say, people like that, because there are a group that we, no matter how partisan or nonpartisan we will attempt to be, will never, ever really see or try to understand what we do. I look over at members and around me at members, and I know how hard they work. I know members that they put in long and hard hours, and when constituents come to them and tell them about what constituency is kind of a no-brainer problem, like, okay, you guys just fix that. But the fact is that being in a legislative way is that we live in a kind of a domino world sometimes. And if you move and push one domino, it has a reaction. So, Mr. Speaker, this is what we have to do. And so what we see sometimes is a very simple thing of, say, of a land issue. Well, Jumpins, they've been using that land for this many years. Why can't you just change it? But as we find with many laws, people realize that the simplicity of just changing, just move over there. And it may, while it may have a very reasonable look at it, then we find out, no, well, Jumpins, if we move that, if we kind of move that pebble out of there, then the whole system will fall down. So, Mr. Speaker, these are issues that we have to contend with, and many of us are not lawyers or practicing lawyers, and so many of us have to use what I think got us here is our common sense and our street sense, and that's why I think you look in this House and why many of us have gotten here. It's a respect for our community, and I think a lot of people within our community, if I may be so bold, respect us. So, Mr. Speaker, those are issues that I want to say in this House that's important. I think it's important to say on the record that, you know, it's not a love in here, Mr. Speaker, and it's tough go. Well, you know, if you consider getting a kiss from Bill Estabrooks as a love in, Leonard, or the member from Sable Island, then you've, as my children would say when they were younger, you've got issues.
We know that.
But what I want to say is, look, folks, this is a very difficult job, and a job that everybody wants to do their best in, as in any work life. But we have a very unique set of circumstances here, because we're entrusted, we're empowered by the people of Nova Scotia to do a job, and we're to do the best job for them. And as long, my friends, as we can keep who put us here and who can take us out as our prime motivation for being here, doing the right things for Nova Scotians, then we're on the right track. So, Mr. Speaker, whatever we do, always remember, and I know members in this House, to a vast majority, agree that they do the best they can for the people, whether it's Hants West, whether it's Cape Breton North, whether it's Cape Breton Centre, whether it's Timberley Prospect, whether it's Queens, but whether it's Dartmouth North. Mr. Speaker, we all face a challenge. But with that said, never, ever underestimate the challenge our constituents have to live up with every day. And that's what we have to temper what we do with. So, Mr. Speaker, with those few words and the kind indulgence of the members across the way,
and behind you,
I and But those members across the way. Mr. Speaker, I want to thank my members for indulging me in these few moments. But, you know, whatever the future brings for any of us, my time with everybody in this House, and indeed the time to be able to say whenever God calls me or whenever, Mr. Speaker, I will look and say, I've worked for and I've worked with the greatest people in the world. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you, Honourable Member. The Honourable Government House Leader.
Yes, Mr. Speaker, could we be, with the indulgence of the House, could we, and they're going to say no now. Mr. Speaker, could we, with the indulgence of the House, revert back to presenting reports of committees?
Is that agreed?
Agreed.
Presenting reports of committees.
I take it all back.
Okay, the Honourable Government House Leader.
Mr. Speaker, would you please call bills for second reading, Bill 1.
Bills for second reading, Bill number 1. The Honourable Deputy Premier.
Okay, Mr. Speaker, it's my understanding that this bill was adjourned by the member from Cumberland South. So, Mr. Speaker, we had advised members that we would not proceed past second reading on that bill until the regulations with that bill were tabled. I now have, on behalf of the Premier, he's not available, but I will be tabling the regulations as it relates to Bill 1.
Okay, the regulations are tabled.
And now, Mr. Speaker, I would call second reading of Bill 1.
Second reading on Bill 1. The question has been called. Are we ready for the question? All those in favour signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those against say nay. The motion is carried.
Bill number 1, entitled an Act to Establish a Management Commission for the Effective Administration of the House of Assembly.
Order this bill be referred to the Committee on Law Amendments. The Honourable Government House Leader.
Yes, Mr. Speaker, if we could just take about a 5-minute recess, and when we'll have a report back from law amendments.
We'll have a short recess.
Agreed. Thank you.
please. I will call the House back to order, and I'll recognize the Honourable Government House Leader.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. With the approval of the House, could you please revert order of business to presenting reports of committees?
Agreed.
You said agreed?
Agreed.
Presenting reports of committees, the Honourable Minister of Justice.
Mr. Speaker, as Chair of the Committee of Law Amendments, I am directed to report that the committee has met and considered the following bills: Bill number 62, the Nova Scotia Hospital Foundation Act, and Bill number 67, the Halifax Regional Municipality Charter. The committee recommends these bills to a favorable consideration of the House without amendments.
Order these bills be referred to the Committee of the Whole House on Bills. Honourable Minister of Justice.
Mr. Speaker, as Chair of the Committee of Law Amendments, I am directed to report that the committee has met and considered the following bill: Bill number 50, the Police Act, the Corrections Services Act, and Charter Chapter 31 of the Acts of 2004, the Police Act. The committee recommends this bill to a favorable consideration of the House with certain amendments.
Order that these bills be referred to the Committee of the Whole House on Bills. The Honourable Government House Leader.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Again, with the assistance of members from all sides of the House, that concludes the government's business for today. Monday, we will be doing bills. We'll be doing Committee of the Whole, hopefully third reading of bills, and that time permits, address and reply to the speech in the throne. So, Mr. Speaker, I wish you to now leave the chair and to meet from the hours of 4 p.m. to 10 p.m. on Monday.
The motion is to adjourn until 4 p.m. on Monday. Ready for the question? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those against say nay. The motion is carried. We are adjourned till 4 p.m. Monday.